I'm his preacher freak. Didn't really mean come see me. You know it's a fee for features. She told me that she's 21. Her record still clean and she I looked a bit dead in the eye. Told her go get some
more. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Hi K Crew, how you doing? So hey guys, today, as you guys can see by the title, today is going to be how to make a thumbnail video. So first we're going to go on Fonto, and then we are going to click the camera button at the bottom. Then we're going to put plain image, and then we're going to go to, you could pick white or black, but I'm going to pick white today. So then you're going to go up there where the little bars is. Oh, by the way, you guys, sorry, I forgot that I did this, but you could change the colors and all of that, as you guys will see, you know, various of colors and a color scheme or whatever. You guys can pick whatever you want, and now you're going to go change this image size. So you're going to put 1280 and as the width, and then for the height, you're going to put 720. So, and then when you have that, you're going to use, you're going to click use, and then you're going to add, say if you want to, like, you know, do like something with the photos, you can go to your add photos and all your photos are gonna pop up. Then click a photo, click done, increase it in size or decrease it in size. You can do however you want, and you can also style it how you want, and it's basically all up to you. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna do like a side to side photo. So like I'm gonna get the same photo and then do like a side to side. And these ones, I feel like, are kind of hard because, you know, you got to get it the perfect size. And I never seem to do it right, but these are my favorite type, but they're hard to actually do. So, but I do them anyway. So, you can, once you get it to a point where you feel like it's good enough, a way that you can figure out it's good enough is you can save it and go to your photos, which I will show you in a little bit. I would speed up this process, like, what am I doing? Anyways, as I continue, so now I'm gonna save the photo, and then I'm just gonna go to my photos, and then you're gonna see it right here, and your gallery is gonna be the most recent photo, of course, and you can just check it out and see if you like it. So if you don't, you could just adjust it how you want it or whatever. But there's also, you can add text to your photo, and there is you can get different type of fonts for your text. We can go on thefont.com, and that's where I get all my fonts from. It's called thefont.com, and the link will be in the description, so you guys can check it out if you want to. And basically, these are all, well, majority of my fonts, but I'm just going to change to a font. Just some random font, just to show you guys real quick or whatever. So, you can also change the color of it, you know, it's all of these different colors, and you could change the stroke of it, the thickness, the width of it, all of that, and you could change the text color, size, all that, like I'm saying. And you could, oh, shadow it. Yeah, you could shadow it and make it like in these different type of shadows, as you guys could see, like for the back of your text. And then you could just add it right up there, wherever you want. You could place it anywhere you want, and there's a lot of different ways to adjust it. You could tilt it, you could tilt it and, you know, make it left, right, do all the extra stuff. You could curve it, make it 3D, erase. That's a whole nother app, and I think you gotta pay for that though. But yeah, that is a part of that. And then what you could do is save that image. Or, well, I reset it mine, but I'm going to show you guys something. This is another way you can do this. So, what I'm going to do is go to We Heart It, and I'm going to find me a nice aesthetic background for you guys. For example, I like aesthetic backgrounds because, in my opinion, they are really cute. And you just got to find the right one, though. It takes pretty much of time to find the right one, especially when you're a really picky person like I am. Because, you know, your girl be too picky sometimes. But anyways, we're going to look for a cute aesthetic background. I don't know why I put wallpaper at first, but yeah, we're just going to skim through this. This is what I always do. It takes me pretty much some time just to get up in here and find one. But I'm going to just use this one just only because it's an example video. Anyways, y'all could pick whatever y'all want, and y'all could pick whatever y'all choices. But anyways, like I said, the width will be 1280, and then the height will be 720. And then we're just gonna use that, and then we're just gonna, you know, oops, I clicked the wrong thing. God, Jesus. So all photos, and we're gonna do this, and then we're just gonna tilt that baby, and we're gonna make sure it's at a 90 degree angle. But knowing me, I probably put it at a 91 degree angle, which doesn't matter anyway. But it's still gonna come out the same. But since this has a little heart in the middle, you might want to make sure that it's kind of on point and don't make it too oversized. See, look at me putting it on like 92 angle and stuff. But yeah, I'm just gonna save that, and you could just check that out up in your photos just to see how it looks and if it's like perfect. And it's perfect to me, so I'm good. And then, you know, you could just add your little text. I'm just gonna put, for example, just Kyla. What should I put? Kyla Vlogs, or, oh, Kyla Tube. Okay, so yeah, I've got Kyla Vlogs and the other one, so I forgot. So we're just gonna put Kyla Tube here, and then we're gonna put Kyla Tube at the top. And yeah, this is just an example, guys. I would never make this type of thumbnail, but just saying. Not saying there's anything wrong with it, but I'm just saying, this just ain't me. I be having to be extra and all that. But then we're gonna go to YouTube Studio. Then we're just gonna click on a random video, and then when you click on that video, you're gonna go to the top where it has that pencil thing, and then you're gonna press edit thumbnail, and then it's gonna have change at the bottom. And then that, my friend, is how you create a banger thumbnail. And I hope you guys enjoy. Make sure you guys don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I love you, K Crew, and I will see you guys on my next video.